Moses blessed the sheep and harvest and put it that place on the gate of the house. It means that the angel of the death comes. When he sees that blood, he just pass. He just pass. He just pass. Can't see it. There are. Having that sticker say only man or mother, Jesus. If anybody has that sticker, he says, the angels can pass. And keep on living. And this is the message. The message is not that. The message is what the Lord says. When everybody sees that sticker in his house, in his car, wherever he landed, he says, he's going to remember, I have to be. He says, I am going to know who is ready. My coming. Only ready people never take it. He says, only those of the one who's ready, they will receive that sticker.
Amen.
Don't keep, listen what the Lord says. Hey, Abel, look on the time of
did not.
I know. When Noah arrived on the earth, he didn't think federal service about his uncle, federal service about his mother-in-law.
Yes.
No. What it is, his sacrifice. The sacrifice. Look at him. The snake was inside. The lion was inside. The hyena was inside. The bird was inside. But the man, human beings, they refused to get into the ark. Today God is calling each and everyone to come into the ark. Look at them, the people, testing, grabbing the prophecy, looking for the prophecy from, look, this is, he says, be careful, my son, he's not going to ruin my house. God, what happened? You have got a blood in his hand. He's not going to kill. But I'm not going to allow anyone to do it. One of his sons, they will come and do. Who is that? The person who came over from the fornication, King Saul. God chose him from the last moment when he gave a birth to him. No, he just gave the son to build the house. God never had sinners. He had sin.
Oh, yes.
Still the aim of Jesus Christ come to the world. He came to save us. He came to bind us. He came to cleanse us. He didn't judge us. Nathan came. That's one of the questions what Nathan did. In the second Samuel chapter 12 verse 1. Secondly, if you go to 2 Samuel chapter 1 verse 1, I didn't say go. Listen, just write down and listen. Don't miss this. Today is something very unique. It's controlled all the prophet 1 after prophet chapter 5. Look at the second thing what this unique prophet what he did. When he killed David, he took somebody's wife, like that's his wife. A woman became pregnant. And he killed the husband of that woman because of his intention. Because of what he was looking for. King David forget what was the past. What he was struggling in the desert. What he was in the underground. What King Saul was doing on him. He forget completely when he became a father. When he became a king. He was looking for somebody's wife to cheat on him. And God said, even though King David, he was on the top of the palace, on the top of heaven, his Lord is watching over him. But then when you try to hide, there's somebody watching over from him.
Yes.
But then when you look like a righteous, God is watching you. You are not a righteous. If you are still keep sinning, God is watching you over from heaven.
Yes.
They're not going to look you white, they're not going to look the name of God. You are waiting one day to reap what you sow the seed. The seed is
Makalabas.
King David wanted to do whatever he wanted. That is good to feel that day. You understand? King, you want to use her and send her back. But she conceived. Suddenly she came and she said, King, I'm sorry, I'm conceived. What? I'm pregnant. I'm coming to the palace, if you believe or not. Sometimes a woman, she's going to say, I'm going to come to your house. I want to meet your wife. What are you going to do?
Very old. But the Sunamite woman
doesn't even let him because he's giving power. Not that he's holding it. He didn't say anything, he didn't touch it, he didn't kiss it. The woman is in the palace. But this his son was looking over this woman every day. You know, some of us we are our calling is for a woman. When we see woman, the professor. This is Adam's father. He was watching over this. One day, you are belongs to me. I have to declare I become a king. He was speaking in tongues. He called the army leaders and what? He declared a king. Now I'm here. He got to Persia and he said, Adonai, we already declared he became a king. What I know is, King David promised for your son, for Solomon, he's the next king. What? What must I do? Go to the king? Or be next king? In this chapter, what he did is, he sent Bathsheba, the mother of Solomon, to speak the truth. And the king, he must say something. Suddenly, when Bathsheba was discussing with the king, he is already in the middle of the house. He says, who is in the house? Nathan says, I am. Always the prophet, the true prophet, is stand for the truth. Amen.
The kingdom.
Why he asked me the woman today is
He said, he declared, I have gone to God. I declare in the name of Jesus. I am investing in the name of Jesus. He is not going to touch his blood in my name, Jesus. Receive it. Receive it in Jesus' name.
This is the second thing, but this king, this prophet, he did it. He do a lot of things like this. This is one of the best suffering, but I'm forbidden that prophet he did it. The second prophet, who is what we are going to see today, is Prophet Elijah. It's a very unique. If you go to the first Kings chapter 17, when Ahab comes to the king, you know, Ahab is very, very blessed in the previous, before he married the woman of Jezebel. He is from the kitchen. He is from the very good family. Therefore, when this king becomes, this prophet becomes. He's a sister. He's an ordinary man from the ordinary village as a soldier. There's no good name for his father or his village, whatever it is. Suddenly, this prophet came. He's a very highly anointed. He's very unique. He's the one who killed 450 plus 450, 900 prophets. He took the power from the very prophet. Therefore, what happened is, this prophet was given to the Israelites. He tried to shape. He tried to shape the Israelite in a righteous way, in a godly way. But the Israelite doesn't want to listen to him. After so long, I'm just touching. I didn't preach about Elijah. You know, if I preach a lot, but I'm just saying something. Listen to me. At the end, what happened is, he gets angry by the people are doing. Evil spirit is taking a place. Evil people are manifesting. You know, they are becoming upgraded and they are becoming prosperous. Everything is not the way of what they expect. God wants to do something. Even Elijah doesn't know. It's not the will of the Elijah. It was the will of the Lord. It's just walking inside of that prophet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Of the inhabitants of Gilead said to Ahab,
city person. And why you are not for all the Israelites? And why you guys are for all the Israelites? Why did he say, hey, you are wrong? Why are you not in the heaven? These people are going to die. He says, go. Go. And that's it, you are right. He goes. Until the river finished, the water was there, but the flesh and bread was delivered by the Reuben. Look at that, Reuben, how he's faithful. When God sent the Reuben, he's faithful. For your life, the God is going to send the Reuben here. She had a factory of oil. But she never
same organ. The oil is different by itself. I prophesy upon your life when you come for a prayer. Receive this unendless fire in your life. Because you receive me. Because you receive me. Receive it in Jesus' name.
If he's not resting, whatever he speaks, you know, he's meant to receive. How are you going to receive?